It's time for your daily crypto update with Framework Fortune Crypto. I'm your host, Ben. Now let's dive in. Apologies before we get started. I lost my voice over the weekend and I'm just now getting it back. So I probably will not be as loud or talking crazy as I normally am. But let's dive in. Bitcoin looks like it was going to try to rebound, having a pullback here. We're starting to get a lot of crazy talk in the economic markets. You know, the U.S. government's very close to defaulting if they don't figure something out with the national debt, which would be disastrous for a lot of reasons. At the moment, though, if we hold support at 43,000 on Bitcoin, we could very easily see another bounce up. And that would be another higher low. So if we get that higher low, if this builds as support as a higher low, we'll see it pop back up, test 45,000. But if it pops up this time, it's got to break 45,000. Go back out to the daily chart. If we don't hold here, we're going to pull all the way back down to probably, I'd say 35,000 before we get a nice bounce again back up to the top of this downtrend. So the market's still a little iffy, a little indecision here, but just looking for 43,000 to hold right now. Ethereum testing 3,000, needs to hold up 3,000. Same situation as Bitcoin. We've been building higher lows. So if this is another higher low, you get a bounce there. Back up to 3,200. But we got two little peaks here. Two little mountains that if it doesn't push back up, we'll see it sell off again to this 2700. We do not want to keep testing these bottom support areas, this 2700, 28, 29, and 3000 itself, because if they all crack, we're coming back down on Ethereum. It's got to hold up here. Looking at the top gainer list, there's not much going on. OKB has popped up some today, about 12 to 15. Nice little move there, but running into this 50-day at the moment, getting held up there. Filecoin still slowly rebounding. I actually did get into this a small position, looking for that bounce up. I think I've been around here in this consolidation, like 56, 57 area, looking for a rebound up to at least that 75 area. Luna still in this consolidation triangle, still looking pretty good above the 10-day, pretty bullish even with this pullback, so that may continue to run. Cardano getting pounded on again, pushed all the way back down to 215, needs to hold there. If it can't hold that support, we could test 2 again, but if we crack 2 on Cardano, it's going to drop. It looks like it may drop anyway, but it needs to get some action. It's had plenty of news lately, and the heads of the project have been all over social media. Still not seeming to matter, so that's pretty sketchy. If nobody's wanting to buy Cardano, they got to give people a reason to buy it. Algorand coming closer and closer to a little squeeze here. 200 days at 164. Top of this trend line's at 175. Algo can pop over 175. It could turn back bullish. If it doesn't, it's probably going to drop down to 150 for a test and maybe even lower. Atom, same thing as Lunaterra. It's still slowly climbing up. We do have a little bit of a consolidation triangle going on right here. So that supported about 36, 35 is holding up. And it's already starting to bounce. So we may see Atom back up to 40 to test soon. Avalanche not looking too bad. I do want to see it bounce here off of this 50-day if it's going to keep ripping. It's held up the 50-day for the most part besides this little drop. So if it cracks the 50-day, expect a pretty big pullback again to that 200 at 56. Polkadot down here close to the trend line. So this could be a potential buying opportunity on it. We just have this downtrend right there that needs to break over. But it's bounced off the trend line so far every other time. So that's a possible play there. Still holding half my fetch. It's right on the 200 now testing. Got to hold up 75 cents here on fetch, and I think it'll turn around and have a nice pop up. If it doesn't, we're going to come back down to the 50 cent area, which I still like fetch long term. So if it does come down to 50 cents, I'll probably take a nice little long term position. But for now, I'm looking for it to still have that rest of this continuation rip. We've consolidated downward nicely, but held most of the gains from the original rip here. So we'll see if it can bounce. H bar on a little trend line. If it can bounce there, it could retest that 35 cent resistance again. Break over that, it'd be back bullish. I haven't talked about Scale Network in a while. It had a nice run up to 50 cents and then even a pullback and back up to 50 cents. We're back down in this area where it started coming back up last time on this rip, so we could see another bounce off of this 30 cent area. If not, we'll see Scale back down to 25 cents, but maybe an interesting opportunity forming there. Now, Solana has been testing the downtrend, gave it a little pop up right there, but getting rejected again. So we still have the 200 at 133. It needs to break. It's got to break within the next, 12 hours above this trend line, basically back above 150 if it's going to push back up. If it doesn't break in the next 12 hours, we'll probably see it drop to 125. Now, Sushi and Uni both got some pops yesterday, but selling off a lot of their gains already. These are the swaps that have not been getting any attention. And with that little rebound, we'll see if they hold up, but they could start becoming plays again now that they are getting a little bit of action if Bitcoin and Ethereum hold up. We'll see what happens there. Voyager token down to that 225. I'm still waiting with the new tokenomics on this to see where the bottom is going to be, because there is some really good benefits you can get now with the Voyager token holding it in Voyager. So I just want to find a bottom before I get in, because I would like to get a decent amount to get some of those benefits. In the meantime, it can always get a little rebound pop if you're looking for a swing trade. We could see a bounce off of 225 here soon if we see all these other bounces I've been talking about. If you are a fan of the Cosmos ecosystem and you like persistence has had a nice little sell-off. Let's move this out of here. And it's down in this 850 area. If it can hold there, it may be a place to pick some up at. I'm going to be watching it close. I may pick some up there because I am staking it. And that would bring my cost down a little bit because I'm in a little higher than that. Not a whole lot, but just a little higher. And that, getting persistence at that price is not a bad price. It's a strong support area. Now, we have kind of been seeing a consistent theme of the beginning of the week, crypto's dropping off and then rebounding some by the weekend. So that's what I'm expecting. I'm looking for that rebound. If we do not get it this week, then we are going to probably start entering into a pretty bearish crypto market. With all the economic and financial craziness that's going on right now, I'd even call it a financial crisis. Really, we're probably beyond that. I think it's going to be a choppy market for a little while. And it's the same thing with stock market and gold and silver. We're getting crazy choppy volatility. Investors and traders are definitely on pins and needles right now. Until we confirm a certain direction out of this consolidation in the crypto markets, everything's going to be a bit sketchy. But let's hop in the news. There's a story I want to cover. Ethereum developer Virgil Griffith pleads guilty to conspiracy charge in North Korea sanctions case. Now I want you to read this right here. Griffin was charged with violating sanctions law by giving a cryptocurrency and blockchain presentation at a North Korean press conference in 2019. So he gave a press conference in North Korea and now he's getting a conspiracy charge. And if you read further in this, the plea deal could serve him between 63 to 78 months in prison. He'll be sentenced on January 2022. So we read down here is the actual charge. He was charged with violating a pair of executive orders. So those are presidential orders that prohibit some types of transactions and activities in North Korea, including exporting services by U.S. persons. As a U.S. citizen, Griffin qualifies as a U.S. person, though his primary residence was in Singapore before his arrest. At the center of these allegations was a presentation that he gave to the North Korean conference. While the specifics of the presentation have not been released, attorneys who commented on the case know that much of the material may have already been public. So this guy, developer of Ethereum, is getting hit with possible 5 to 10 year jail time for giving a presentation on cryptocurrencies. Now, if you think that the governments are not at war right now trying to stop cryptocurrencies from spreading, I mean, they're giving out sentences for people giving presentations. I don't really think there's much more I need to say about it. I think anybody in their right mind would see how ridiculous this is. But you know, check the full article out. It'll be down in the description below. We gotta fight this. Keep spreading the adoption of cryptos. Share this video. Tell your friends, And if you haven't yet, go ahead and hit that subscribe button and give me a like. Let me know you're enjoying this content. Appreciate everybody joining me as always. Stay safe out there. Until next time.